Welcome to Week 13 of Football Fridays in Georgia here on Georgia Public Broadcasting. Tonight, it is a rainy night in Georgia for the first round of the playoffs as the Lassiter Trojans host the Lions of Peachtree Ridge.
Ahead, we're down to the last few hours of our Stop the Drop contest, so if you want to win a cool $1,000, you might want to pay attention. Plus, construction is going to begin on our playoff pyramid because they're just a little more fun than brackets.
Hey, put that remote down. Stick around, because Extra Point's coming up next with me and my main man, Trey.
That's right. This game's going to come down to just a few plays. It should be a close one, and we'll tell you why.
So it's the Lions of Peachtree Ridge. It's the Trojans of Lassiter. The All-Access Pass pregame show is coming up next live on GPB. Welcome to Football Fridays in Georgia's All-Access Pass. It is a wet and wild night here in the state of Georgia. Across the state, 192 teams and 7 classifications have qualified for postseason play. This weekend, 160 of those teams will begin their quest for a state title. Only 80 teams will remain after tonight. Hi again, everybody. We are live in Marietta for this one.
And it's do or die for Peachtree Ridge and Lassiter. They have to win tonight if they are going to go on. Only one of them will advance to the next level. And we are keeping track on all 80 of those games going on across the state of Georgia tonight via social media. So let's check in with our social media correspondent, Grace Olson, with a look at what people are talking about. Grace?
Thanks, Claire. I woke up early this morning, and I have to say, right when I checked Twitter, Peachtree Ridge and Lassiter fans, students, and athletes were already on there pleading their case for why they're going to win this battle out here tonight at the Frank. So this is definitely an exciting time to be a part of social media. So join the thousands that are already part of the GPB sports community on Instagram, on Facebook, and on Twitter. I'm going to keep you updated and posted all night long through those outlets. Now, we've got a big Class 6A game coming your way, but there are 158 other teams across the state tonight looking to make their way to the second round of the playoffs. That's 80 games. That's a lot. So you need to go to gpb.org/sports and click on the playoff brackets tab. Here you'll find the class single A, public and private, all the way through 6A playoff brackets. Just click on the bracket you want to see and all the information will be right there. It's also available on the GPB football app that you can download for your iPhone or your iPad, and it doesn't cost you a penny, so download it now. Now, I went out to the football practices this week at Lassiter and Peachtree Ridge to see how these guys are preparing for tonight's game. I spoke to offensive tackle Orlando Brown of Peachtree Ridge, the quarterbacks of both teams, and I put a little video story together. I wanted to hear how they're preparing for tonight and what they're looking out for most in their competitor. So I tweeted the link to that video. I also posted it on Facebook and at gpb.org/sports. So check out that story and see how these guys have prepared for tonight. I'm going to send it back over to Mark on the set.
You know, one thing I don't think they did prepare for too much is all this rain. It wasn't supposed to come in this early.
No, and you know, we were talking about would Lassiter have home field advantage. Well, with all the rain, the sidelines are exceedingly quiet. And that's partially because people just don't want to get wet, but it's also because a few of the football cheerleaders are missing from the sidelines this evening. That's because this weekend they have to win a championship of their own.
Yeah, take it!
The Lassiter competition cheerleading team is hoping to take the title this weekend at the state championships in Columbus.
If you had a doubt.
The team has won their region 4 years in a row, but earned second and third at the state competition the last two seasons.
5, 6, 7, 8.
But Coach Kathy Zingler says this is their year.
I feel that we are much stronger. We got beat last year because of our stunting. It just wasn't as strong as everything else that we had, and I feel this year, as you saw, our stunting is excellent, so I feel pretty good about that.
Coach Zingler says that's because they added stunt-only practices to solidify their skills, and senior Carrie Reed says their routine is designed to show off that hard work.
Our choreographer was really great in giving us the routine that he did, and it's just different than most other high school teams, so I feel like the judges will really like it.
The judges' scores are based on level of difficulty and execution. That's why the team spends 2.5 hours a day in this gym. And the cheerleaders say all the hours of eight counts, tumbling, and stunting have created a team unity that can't be beat.
We've just grown so close, and I really think it really helps on a team when we kind of treat each other like sisters and we pick on each other, but it's really helped this year, and I really think we're ready.
Ready for state. That team, they are in Columbus right now getting ready for their championship tomorrow, but the co-ed championships are happening right now, and you can watch them live at gpb.org/sports. Just look for the cheerleading stream. You can also watch Lasseter compete tomorrow as well. But if you've got other plans tomorrow, that's okay. We've got you covered. We are going to broadcast a condensed version of the championships, including all the routines you're going to want to see. That is going to start Saturday, November 23rd, right here on GPB from 5 to 6 p.m. with repeats throughout the weekend.
You know, you can watch live the game. You can go on the stream. You can do the, what they call it, the two-screen effect or whatever.
Yeah, you just can't get enough championships this weekend. Why not watch football and cheerleading at the same time?
If I was hipper, I'd say the two-screen experience. That's what it's called. But it's a lot of fun. Okay, the energy, the incitement. There is a vibe of a big game tonight. So let's go live to John Nelson, who's got Mark Fleet with the Peachtree Ridge coach alongside. John?
Thank you, Mark. Here with Fleet. And my first question to you is, what comments do you have about the gentleman shooting this interview, one of your old teammates, Phil Proctor?
I'm telling you, he just came out there a while ago on the field, and I saw him. I thought I heard him say Fleet, and I looked, and I couldn't see who it was with the lights, and I said, goodness, look who that is right there. But we had a lot of fun together, and it was a great time at South Carolina.
All right, let's talk about the game. This is not a typical 1-4. You can throw the records out, throw the seeds out, and everyone's talking about Region 7 being one of the toughest gauntlets all season long, and it has been for you guys.
Well, it is, and I hope it's prepared us, because we've surely have faced some good teams, and of course tonight's another good team. So I'm just looking forward to playing the game, and hopefully, like you said, that going through Region 7 has prepared us a little bit, so we're ready.
And at the same time, a lot of folks talk about expanding playbooks, compressing playbooks, and all that kind of stuff. What is your approach when it comes to this time of year in game 11, 12, 13, 14, 15? Do you throw in wrinkles, or is it getting back to basics?
Well, I really think it's doing what you do good and making sure you concentrate on that, the things that have gotten you where you are, and just try to execute and make sure, you know, it's been a 10-week season. Then we had two off weeks, and we have a three-week preseason. So, you know, we've been down here. So the thing hopefully that you've done is you're executing a lot better. It takes you a little bit less time, and you're sharper and crisper as you go. But, you know, we want to stick with the things that we've done.
And at the same time, you talk about your quarterback, Chance Thrasher. He is no longer the inexperienced kid we saw at the Corky Kell Classic.
No, he's not. And he's grown up quite a bit, and it's been fun to watch him grow. And I just hope he continues on that track. And I mean, he's a kid that practices hard each week. He prepares. He watches film. I mean, everything that you want him to do, this guy does. And so, I'm proud of him. It seems like a long time since the Kell game in the dome, and then where he has come.
All right. Well, good luck tonight, Fleet. Go get dry.
Thank you.
All right. Let's send it over to Mark for the driest part of the house right now, and that's the early word from Peachtree Ridge.
All right. Thank you very much, John Nelson. Peachtree Ridge comes into this game with a 7-3 record, but all three of those losses came to teams ranked in the top 10. Lasseter comes in region champs and on a 5-game winning streak, so both these teams have been tested. Let's check in now with our play-by-play team of Trey McDaniel and Keelan Johnson for a little chalk talk in a segment we call Extra Point. Guys,
very much, Mark. Tonight we've got our first playoff game of the season. Keelan, this ought to be a good game. That's not your typical number one seed versus number four seed, so let's break down who has the advantage in this game, and let's start with the Lasseter Trojans.
Well, first and foremost, Will Anderson is the leader of this football team, Trey, and he has a big responsibility. Number seven, he's a part of the run game and the passing game, because Lasseter don't do a lot of downhill, north-south. Their passing game is their running game with the short passes down the field, okay? So watch out for him. I really like the way they operate on offense.
Yeah, let's talk about the rushing attack for Peachtree Ridge. They want to be balanced on offense, and they have started running the spread beginning this season, but they still want to run the football. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about number one, Jordan Ellis. This young man has over 1,300 yards on the ground. They've scored 25 rushing touchdowns. Mr. Ellis has 24 of them.
Exactly.
He is a huge weapon on offense. They have a big advantage in the rushing attack due to the Peachtree Ridge Lions.
I understand what you're saying, Trey, but I'll have to go to the offensive line. They do so much for this football team, actually on the defensive line too as well. The offensive line, they have big hands, all right, and feet, okay? And what they do well with their hands and their feet, they use those lanes to move those D linemen out the way, and they open those holes for the running backs. They're good, and they are top for their team.
One thing for the Peachtree Ridge Lions, a huge advantage is defensive speed, which they'll need against this huge rushing and passing attack, multidimensional attack for Lassiter. They have 9 interceptions versus just 4 interceptions on the opposite side. This is going to be a heck of a football game.
Right.
Like I said, stay tuned for kickoff. Not your typical number 4 seed versus number 1 seed. I can't wait for this one. Back to you, Mark and Claire.
All right, guys, we're looking forward to the call. Coming up on the All Access Pass, I will talk with Jeff Irwin, the head coach of the Lassiter Trojans, who talks about his season, his team, and this big playoff game.
And we'll check out the opening round of the playoffs to pinpoint some of tonight's biggest games. That and much more as Football Fridays and Georgia's All Access Pass continues right here on GPB.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is made possible in part by Regions Bank. It's time to expect more. Georgia's Electric Membership Corporation, lighting the way. Technical College System of Georgia, learn more, earn more. And by viewers like you, thank you.
This is you. You're a Georgia high school student, full of fresh ideas and a desire to make a difference in your school and community. Well, now's your chance. GPB wants you to help stop the drop by showing us why it's important to stay in school. Grab a camera, maybe a friend or two, and create a 30-second video PSA. Why do your peers drop out? What's a solution? All ideas are welcome. Check out the full details at gpb.org/stopthedrop and get going.
Football Fridays in Georgia is live every Friday on GPB during football season, and you never know who you're going to run into. Sometimes it's a very famous comedian who thinks you might be a redneck. I've interviewed Jeff Foxworthy before, but this was one of those rare times when I got to interview him as a dad. His daughter was homecoming queen.
I'm thrilled for her tonight. This is her night.
And I also got to tell everyone what Jeff's middle name is. I cannot wait for this season of Football Fridays. Go online and let us know some of your favorite moments.
Each week, GPB brings you the latest in high school sports.
Hi again, everybody.
But we want to hear what you have to say. Tell us what's going on with your team. Share your favorite moments. Post your own pictures and videos. And let everyone know why your team will go all the way.
I think it's the best you've ever seen. You haven't seen a game until you've been to one of the games.
Just log on and like us on Facebook, where you can post comments, pictures, and videos to earn your own team bragging rights. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter, too.
Look at the rain come down in Marietta. Welcome back to our GPB All Access Pass pregame show as we get ready for Peachtree Ridge and the Lassiter Trojans.
Well, you know, in basketball, they call playoff time March Madness, but maybe this is November no sunshine or November, I don't know, nonsense or something like that.
It could be something. Whatever it is, it's pressure packed and they're ready to play. Scholars estimate that it took the Egyptians about 20 years to build each of the great pyramids at Giza. That's an astonishing achievement. Well, we're going to try to match that or even top that a little bit. Over the course of the next 5 weekends, we will complete and construct 7 high school playoff pyramids. And John Nelson now joins us to talk a little bit about the pyramid of success.
November to remember.
Let's start off right with this game right here, right now.
Well, if you saw the interview that we had with Coach Mark Fleetwood of Peachtree Ridge, this is not your typical Region 7 versus Region 5, 4 versus 1. throw out the seeds, throw out the region, but a lot of folks are looking at Region 7 to roll tonight.
Okay, North Gwinnett ranked number one takes on Milton.
And I think a lot of it goes to the injury status of quarterback Hayden Spire with North Gwinnett. How healthy is he? You've seen what Milton's done here on Football Fridays with Coach DeChris DeFerro and their great running attack. Interesting, contrasting styles there.
The defending champs in 6A, Norcross, they take on Etowah tonight.
And a lot of folks thought after that first loss of the year to Miami Booker T, 55-0, that Norcross was going to be in a world of hurt. All the seniors, all the talk, new quarterback, all the graduation. They're hitting full song at the right time. Etowah started well at the top of the region, had the region championship in their own hands, but kind of faded toward the end of the year. So which Etowah team shows up tonight? That's the big question.
All right, the pyramid continues in 5A. We talk about the Tucker Tigers, ranked number one, undefeated. They've been very impressive all year long, and they're going to take on Heritage of Conyers.
You talk it with ones and fours, and we also are going to introduce a word tonight, buzzsaw. This is going to be one of those games. Heritage Conyers is in for a very long evening against the Tucker Tigers.
All right, MLK Gainesville, this one is going to be a speed trap.
And I think it's going to go until Tuesday when we have that final score. Go to gpb.org and check out the finals. They're going to go all night long.
All right, in 4A, one of the games I just can't wait to find out what's going to happen to this one. Cedartown with their great players going against Sandy Creek, the defending 4A champs.
Nick Chubb's running attack against Sandy Creek's defense. That's the big matchup tonight down in Tyrone. Interesting to see how it turns out.
All right, Northwest Whitfield and Carrollton, both those teams have had excellent seasons.
Remember that seven-letter word we talked about earlier, buzzsaw? Northwest Whitfield may have it tonight. Carrollton is an angry two-seed after losing the region to Sandy Creek.
All right, in 3A, let's talk about a team that's been at the top of that pyramid for a long time, the Buford Wolves.
But you have to give a shout-out to the Sonoraville Phoenix making the playoffs with a 4-6 record. That seven-letter word, buzzsaw, they're going to get it tonight. Buford's going to roll.
All right, in 2A, Lamar County, undefeated, ranked number one. You were down there just a couple of weeks ago.
And Franklin Stevens has done a tremendous job taking over what Jason Strickland built. Metter is going to probably meet that seven-letter word again. Lamar County, a lot of folks say, has one of the easier routes to the Dome this year.
And tell everybody about the app and the website because they can get all this information. Maybe even the pyramids. We might even put that up there, the pyramid of success.
Did you know that the pyramids were actually supposed to be square when they were built?
You know, you told me that earlier. I didn't know that.
It's an old wives' tale. Go to the app, download it. The app is free. You can catch up with all 405 football playing teams around the state. Go to gpb.org/sports. You can download it there too. And if you have an Android phone, you can go to the website, catch up with all the scores, download, go to the web, watch us on the web at gpb.org, unless you're actually watching us on GPB TV, which is really what we'd like for you to do.
You know, you can watch, you can log on right now for tonight, Friday, but tomorrow you can get all those scores, all those brackets, and who we're going to go, where we're going to play next week.
That, yes.
All right. Thanks, John. We'll see you in just a little bit.
I'm not leaving.
All right. The Lassiter Trojans are region champs. They are on a five-game winning streak last night. And right before the game, I talked to Jeff Irwin, the head coach of the Lassiter Trojans, and asked him about how the season had gone so far this year.
Well, we started off the year pretty inconsistent. We were 2-3, and then the last five games all in the region, our last six region games, we've been able to play really well. So after the bye week, beating Walton, you know, we've been able to finish the regular season strong. So really proud of our effort and how we've improved.
Five wins in a row, region champs. You guys are coming in with a lot of momentum at the right time of the year.
Yeah, you want to be in that situation coming into the playoffs. I mean, if you lose two or three and kind of, you know, back your way into the playoffs, it's not good. So winning the region title last week at home, senior night, kind of finishing the regular season on an upswing, you know, really helped us have some momentum going into this week's game.
Your quarterback, Will Anderson, has had a big season, 21 touchdowns, just seven interceptions and 2,300 yards. Talk about his play.
Well, he stepped right in at the quarterback position after, you know, a couple games getting used to his receivers and the system and playing 6A football because he had played in a smaller classification last year. And he's just done a great job leading us. He's very calm, very poised, can make all the throws, and has done a great job learning and running our offense.
The Frank will be rocking tonight. Talk about the home field advantage for you guys.
Yeah, our crowd, our students are really excited to have another playoff game at home. You know, we were 4-0 at home this year. We won on homecoming and won on senior night, which every coach wants to do that. And we're really excited to have you guys here. And we hope Peachtree Ridge brings a big crowd and should be a great game tonight.
Jeff Irwin, thanks so much for coming on with us and good luck tonight against Peachtree Ridge.
Thanks a lot, Mark.
It may be soggy here in the Frank, but these fans are enthusiastic, and this should be a really good game. You know, now, every team has its star players that have played on Saturday, and some have even played on Sunday.
And when you think about the sheer number of not just high schools, but high school football players, even peewee players across the country, it really is something to be proud of when you have somebody go on to the pro level. And so John Nelson is here to talk to us a little bit more about that.
I'm still trying to figure out how you ended up with a dry interview in this show.
The magic of television, my friend. Let's talk a little bit about right off the top about Cameron Haywood, because he had a great career here, had a great career at Ohio State, and he's having a great career in college or in pros.
Now you have Cameron Haywood here. He played both sides of the ball at Peachtree Ridge, had a little running back, played on the defensive line as well, and he is part of that Peachtree Ridge pipeline with the NFL players and the dads who have their sons now with the Pittsburgh Steelers, and son of Ironhead. I just like to say that. Son of Ironhead, second generation.
And Hayward's teammate, Drew Butler, a name I'm familiar
yes.
with. Yes. Class of 2007.
I'm going to go ahead and say this. Everyone knows his dad, Kevin, was Butthead when he was at the University of Georgia. So I guess technically Drew is son of Butthead, a tremendous punter at the University of Georgia, a tremendous special teams player for Peachtree Ridge, part of the championship team that tied Roswell at McEachern. And now they've had cups of coffee with the Steelers. Very cool.
I tell you, it's fun to watch these guys progress. You see them play in the high
right.
school level, then they go on play at Saturdays, and then some of them play on Sundays, and it's just a lot of fun.
And you think about the numbers that Georgia has. Georgia, when it comes to college athletes, is a top five state when it comes to high school players going to college, and the percentage of players that make it from the college ranks in Georgia to the NFL. That's a great thing to see, too, and they're always ending up to be great representatives for the state as well.
Well, and now what's really cool is we have all these colleges in Georgia who've added football programs, so now we're just going to see even more of these kids get to move on.
Six of them have added football this year, and that's, again, the expansion of the sport here in the South.
All right, we'll see you in just a second. Coming up on the All Access Pass, hey, this guy, John, he's
going
to stick around.
I'm not
for
going
John's
anywhere.
Georgia. He can't go anywhere. It's dry here where he is. He doesn't want
yeah,
to go out there.
Yeah, I don't
there.
Like to go anywhere when it's wet.
He's got the story of three teams that have made it to the playoffs this year.
As we continue our Stop the Drop campaign, time is running out on your chance to win $1,000. You're going to want to stick around. That and much more as Football Fridays in Georgia's All Access Pass continues on GPB.
Sometimes you get inspiration in the most unusual way. If you're a Georgia high school student, you can enter GPB's video contest, win $1,000, and make a difference. How can you help stop the drop?
This week on Georgia Traveler, we're all about Poseidon and the Peach State.
Prepare to fly.
Whoa! Just believe you can fly. It sounds corny, but you gotta listen.
Are you ready for an adventure? He knows the way.
Going again.
There you go. Wow.
These grits are Georgia grown grits.
So good.
Student work at Berry is part of the threefold mission.
Sit, stay.
Don't miss the next Georgia Traveler, Sunday at 7.
One of my favorite moments from Football Fridays in Georgia is meeting unsung heroes like Caitlin Wilshire. Caitlin is a member of the Southwest DeKalb Marching Band, and she plays the trumpet. And did I mention she's been in a wheelchair since birth? But nothing can stop her, nothing can even slow her down.
When you go out there, do your whole show, do it right, it feels like you accomplished something.
Meeting her was one of my favorite moments from last year's Football Fridays in Georgia. Log on to GPB Sports Facebook page and tell us about your favorite moments.
GPB, winner of 15 Emmy Awards. Thank you for your support.
Welcome back to the Football Fridays in Georgia All Access Pass pregame show. We are getting ready for the Peachtree Ridge Lions to take on the Lassiter Trojans. It is a wet, rainy night in Georgia, and John Nelson has brought along the appropriate headgear, I think, for that.
For wet?
Yes, John.
Something to cover. I think this is going to get soaked, man.
It might. John has covered high school sports in the state of Georgia for over 20 years. He's written two books on the subject of high school football here in Georgia. He is our resident expert, resident authority.
Yes.
But does this know-it-all?
Know-it-all.
So that brings us to our question of Stump Nelly.
In the hermetically sealed envelope from the mayonnaise jar.
That's right. We keep it there. And, of course,
Mark doesn't have any fingernails, so he can't open the envelope.
Kind of chilly. My fingers aren't working quite right.
Claire,
help
him out.
Which of these schools and high school can boast that they have sent 17 players
17.
To the NFL? Is it A, Griffin, B, LaGrange, C, Marist, or D, Valdosta?
Let's go with A, Griffin.
You are absolutely 100% correct. Griffin has done the job.
Sweet.
All right, and we'll be back with more right after this.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is made possible in part by Regions Bank. It's time to expect more. Georgia's Electric Membership Corporation, lighting the way. Technical College System of Georgia, learn more, earn more. And by viewers like you, thank you.
Capital Cadillac Buick GMC, family-owned and operated and serving Atlanta since 1931, proudly supports the Georgia High School Association and GPB's Football Fridays in Georgia. 2150 Cobb Parkway or capitalbpg.com.
Georgia Peanut Commission, offering power-packed Georgia peanuts as a delicious snack and fuel for the big game. Georgia peanuts are the official state crop of Georgia, with almost half of all peanuts in the U.S. produced by Georgia farmers.
Of the national anthem by the Lassiter Marching Band. Well done. One of our missions here at GPB is to raise awareness of the high dropout rate in the state of Georgia. It's important to stay in school and to get that degree. For more on our Stop the Drop campaign, here's Claire.
Thank you so much, Mark. I would like to welcome in Belisa Urbina. She's the executive director of Ser Familia, a group based right here in Cobb County. Thank you so much for braving the weather for us.
Thank you so much for the invitation.
So tell us, what is Ser Familia?
Ser Familia is a nonprofit organization that helps Latino couples, youth, parents, and families just to have successful daily living through leadership skills, life skills, and better relationships.
Now, I saw somewhat of a disturbing statistic that here in Georgia, nearly 40% of Hispanic students fail to graduate on time. I imagine that's part of what you're trying to prevent.
Certainly. Statistics are, all over the place, and, we might not have the exact number, but it's very close to that, and certainly is a very disturbing number.
And what is it exactly that you think is contributing to this, and what are you guys doing to fix the problem?
I think that part of it is that many of the kids, don't feel like, it's hard to belong when you're, especially most of our kids are second generation. Their parents were born in another place, and sometimes it's hard for the parents just to provide the support because, they are just trying to raise their families, work all the time. So they feel like they are alone, and sometimes they are parenting themselves because they are the first ones that are able to really speak the language. So, they don't have the support many times that they need and, the skills.
And tell me about that language barrier. I understand that sometimes even between parents and their children, it can be difficult.
Yes. The parents, many of our Latino older generation, was born in another place, so their main language is Spanish. So for the kids, their main language is English. So you're going to have a language barrier within a family, which is very hard. Just to give you an idea, sometimes we ask in one of our programs kids and parents to write letters to each other, and we need to find an interpreter for them to be able to read the letters that each other have written.
Wow, that's difficult.
It's very difficult.
And so what's the main thing that you do? Because I understand you work with kids, but you also work with their parents.
It's important to involve the parents and as part of the solution. We cannot work with the kids alone. So we do weekend workshops, we do support groups, we do the strengthening families program. So it's a whole package. So we can not only help the kids, but also involve the parents and strengthen the family.
So if somebody would like to get some more information about your organization, what can they do?
They can either call us on our phone number, or they can access our website, which is www.ser-familia.org.
Thank you so much for being here, Belisa. We appreciate it.
Thank you so much for the invitation.
GPB's Stop the Drop campaign aims to improve graduation rates across Georgia. And time is running out to enter our video contest this year. The deadline for submitting an entry is midnight on Sunday, November 17th. So you've got just a little bit more than 48 hours. So far, we've gotten over 100 entries. They are really good, so you're going to get cracking. All Georgia high school students can still take part by creating a 30-second video PSA. It should tackle the issue of why some kids drop out of school and offer encouragement to at-risk students. You can find full details about how to enter at gpb.org/stopthedrop. Voting starts November 22nd and runs through December 8th. And the video with the most votes on YouTube will win, and the winner is going to be announced at the championships in December. And if you are the one who wins, you will take home $1,000. So remember, less than 48 hours to go. You're going to want to enter. Mark?
Thank you, Claire. We re-welcome in John Nelson.
I never left, man.
The author of four books, two on high school football in the great state of Georgia. Segment we call John's Nelson, brought to you by
Georgia's EMC.
All right, topic number one. We've got a real cat fight between Hughes and Valdosta.
It's a 1-4 in 6A. We'll spend some time in Colquitt. Sonny, Cowie to Fayette, and Greystone Power with Hughes. Willie Cannon's really built something the last couple of seasons. They've got a big game tonight against Valdosta, and his guys know what they're getting into down in Fairburn.
It kind of reminds you a little bit of when you're looking at the NCAA college pool. You know, you never really take a look at the seedings. You take a look at the teams themselves. And Valdosta is definitely not a four as far as in our eyes.
All right, topic number two, a big game in Region 1, 5A.
Three-way tie had to happen, and they had to sort it out by points scored against common opponents with Lee County, Harris County, Thomas County Central. Let's show you how it all finished out in a very wacky Region 1, 5A. Spending time in Diverse Power, Flint Energies, and Grady Mitchell, EMC. Thomas County Central getting on the board. Adam Choice breaking the record for Thomas County Central's career yardage mark over 5,000. But Harris County would win 38-35, and because of that, Mark, Lee County, because they had the least points allowed against them, got the one seed. Harris County the two. Thomas County Central on the road is a three. That's it for topic two. It's topic three.
Topic three is Burke County is back.
And it's because of Gator Green. We're going to spend some time in Jefferson Energy and Planters EMC to let you see how Burke County beat Wayne County for the second time this year, and it's a quirk of the region. It was a region crossover title game. Donquell Green had five touchdowns, including one that he had receiving, 45-49-43 overtime final. Wayne's both of their losses this season, 8-2, were to Burke County, so it looks like the Burke County Bears and Eric Parker are back.
All right, great job. Try to stay dry.
Not happening.
All right, over to you, Claire.
Well, we are now just moments away from kickoff, so let's check in one last time with our social media correspondent, Grace Olson. Grace, you staying dry over there?
I am. Now, it may be raining, but we have got some pumped up fans out here tonight. You can actually see the Peachtree Ridge students. They call themselves the Tribe. They're screaming so loud behind me. They're so excited about tonight's game. I'm going to be retweeting the things they say, the things Lasser says on Twitter. Find GPB Sports on Facebook as well. Download the app and catch the cheerleading state championships tomorrow online at gpb.org/sports, and catch the finals of the co-ed championship right now online. Log in now. Back over to Mark and Claire on the set.
All right, it is that time. We are counting down to kickoff.
All right, it is the Lions of Peachtree Ridge. It is the Trojans of Lasseter. It is game time on Football Fridays in Georgia, live on GPB. GPB.